Unsigned Live with Charlie and Mark.
105.9 Bishop FM.
So yes, we're joined by Celestine in the studio. Hello, guys.
Hello.
All right, how you doing?
So should we just start off by introducing yourselves and what you do?
Yeah. Elliot Fennick, lead vocals. Average guy from Aycliffe, work, stuff like that. Really sing every now and again.
Where do you work?
PWS, just Fit Kitchens, really.
Fit Kitchens. Everyone knows someone who works at PWS.
Isn't that about it, really? Just sing every now and again with these guys if they want to. That's it.
I'm Niall Fennick, related to Elliot, unfortunately. I'm the drummer, and I do a little bit of cheeky backing vocals.
You've got a cheeky tambourine there, I can
yeah.
see.
It's actually it's not even mine, it's his.
It's actually mine. Oh, I'm usually a tambourine warrior, but...
I there's not really much about me. I listen to music a lot, play music a lot, and that's it.
Is tambourine not your first instrument then?
No, triangle was actually...
Okay.
I was there first. Yeah.
A triangle?
The master of all percussion.
But what's it like drumming and singing? Is that hard? Is that taxing?
Depends what song it is.
Phil Collins.
Because, some songs, if I'm playing a quite difficult beat for myself, it's quite hard to sing along, but I usually pick the songs carefully what I'm going to sing along to.
Okay.
It's fun.
And next?
I'm Jack Walker, I'm Barnard Castle, play bass in the band, I'm backing vocals every now and then, a little bit, again. I don't do much like sixth form and that.
Just sixth form and that. What are you taking at sixth form? What do you do?
I took English language, English literature, history and maths.
How's that going?
Yeah, sorry.
Studying hard?
Yeah.
And Joe?
Yeah, I'm Joe, like you said. I'm the musical one, because none of these know what key they're singing in the world. I play guitar and I'm looking at my mic. I like the band.
Since the most he's ever talked, like being speaking to other people. He's usually crazy in practice, but
I've never heard him talk.
When we're performing, he's just keeps himself to himself.
Yeah.
But I'm proud of you, Joe.
Well done.
It's a Bishop FM first. George said his first words live in the video.
Your mother will be proud, Joe.
So Dom's been in touch and he says, "Hi lads, canny cush tunes." So if you want to get in touch, you can call or text to 01388 2070 70.
Or you can head over to the Bishop FM website, bishopfm.com, and click the contact the show button.
Yeah, so actions speak louder than words. Would you like to play a song? Or something to
Well, that'd be nice,
yourselves.
Wouldn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, stay away,
so what song are you going to play for us now?
We're going to do Oasis Supersonic, but like an acoustic version, but we're
slower,
not.
Slower, chilled out vibe.
Right, okay, take it away.
Thank you.
Sit in the car.
Signed Live with Charlie and Mark.
We're here with Celestine. Hi, guys.
Hello.
So we played the Smiths, and on your little Facebook page, it says that you are influenced by them.
What sort of
influences do you have?
Oh, the music.
I
have a quiff. I get told I look like him.
Not right now.
Like Fabiola as well.
Yeah, maybe if you shaved the beard off, you'd just...
Yeah,
you didn't
I've
really
shaved in a while, to be honest.
Oh, it's Morrissey! Whoa!
Yes. No, I need a shave, so...
Gillian was just telling us in the break room a bit earlier about a puppet named Morrissey.
Yeah, a puppet that apparently specialised in consumer rights. So I don't know if that has anything to do with Morrissey.
I just heard the word Morrissey and I was there.
Probably
will
be
known
Morrissey.
What other stuff do you like to listen to?
Oasis, Stone Roses. That sort of stuff.
Because you listed about 9,000 on your Facebook page. Oh, yeah. It's like you've just like looked at a book that has every band ever. And just
we just think of songs in the thing. Like when we're practicing, we're like, we'll do this song. And then sometimes a couple of weeks down the line, we'll forget about it. And then we'll come back to it. Remember when we recorded it? We tried that song.
Yeah. I'm sure there's somewhere in my house there's like a huge list of songs that we're meant to do. Yeah. And we have never done them yet.
So what are the main songs that feature on your set?
We do. Molly's Chambers by King of Leon.
We do Beatles.
We do She Sells Sanctuary by The Cult as well, which is my favourite to play. It's a pretty fun one.
Yeah. So gigs.
Oh god.
Yeah.
Niall's brought the diary.
this needs a jingle.
Right, I think we can think of a jingle. Da, 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 da.
We are Simple Minds.
Okay.
Right.
Well,
that was Simple Minds there. by Simple Minds. What gig's coming up next for Celestine?
September 19th, we are playing at Timothy Ackworth in Shildon.
Not the school.
Not the school, no. We said that before and people were like, oh, didn't know you played schools. It's a pub. we have the Green Tree in Bishop Auckland on the 27th of September. And we're also at the Iron Horse in Newton Aycliffe in October as well.
Had to keep it local.
Andrea's been in touch and she says, well done, lads. Don't be nervous. Just be your fabulous selves.
That's my mum. Thanks, mum.
Thanks, Andrea, for being in touch.
Yeah. What are you having for tea? So you can like have a bit of a conversation with Andrea.
Surprise me, man. Go on.
Okay, Andrea, if you're listening, will you tell us what you're having for tea? We're all dying to know.
Yeah, so speaking of gigs, have you had any gig disasters?
Like tsunamis or tornadoes?
Well, we've once had a group of ninjas once busting us, and then...
That
sounds like a lie.
No, that's straight up.
It's not.
That's why he's called the bouncer over there.
The bouncer. Here we have the bouncer live in the studio.
Yeah,
how did he dispatch the ninjas?
Well, basically, Joe did some tribal belly dancing to like distract them. Then we basically went behind them and just took them all out.
So you can distract ninjas with tribal belly dancing.
Yeah. Joe has a lot of magic tricks.
I didn't know a band would be always that physically capable to like destroy ninjas.
Surprise, we can do everything.
So when you're at practices, do you sort of practice your martial arts
as
well?
Yeah, we never practice the songs, to be honest. We just go out and perform. Most of the time, we're just jumping about the studio.
Yeah.
We should just go to the gym.
The gym's probably cheaper than a practice space.
Probably.
Yeah. So, like, is that on your business card as well?
That we destroy ninjas?
Yeah, that you're training martial arts.
Yeah.
All the time. That's what people ask for, really.
It's the fact that he kills it all the time.
What? we have had some disasters.
It's six packs, isn't it?
Yeah. There's one time we couldn't, like, when we were at one place and there, the speakers were really close to Joe's guitar, and he got a lot of feedback.
A lot of feedback
on his guitar, didn't you, Joe? Well, it still went alright.
Terrible.
You still look traumatised from the event.
We once played a gig with only one speaker as well.
Oh yeah, that was a nightmare. We were at the Cumberland, weren't we?
One speaker?
Yeah, one speaker.
Did he take turns in plugging into the speaker?
We just had to do our best, really, didn't we? Make people bear with us.
We've also had
Elliot
was really good.
Elliot once yawned and pulled a muscle in his throat.
Yeah, that was a
and really he was bad. Really struggling. That was our last gig.
You can do that.
Yeah, I'm a hidden talent. I can yawn and pull muscles. I was sat at home just watching the TV. Nothing special. Just yawned.
I'm sure talent is the right word.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. And pulled a muscle, which kind of was a nightmare for the gig that weekend. We had about 4 weeks off, and like the last week of being off, I pulled a muscle, so I ruined it for that. But we'd still seem to go down all right. We soldiered on.
What a strange place to pull a muscle.
I know. It was awful.
Charlie was wondering earlier, when we were drinking our tea, he was wondering how dirty would a cup have to be for you not to drink out of it?
I'll drink from anything.
Anything?
Yeah.
Have you seen the cups that we have here?
To be honest, some of the pubs I've been in, there's been a lot worse cups than my pants. That still hasn't stopped.
I once had a cup of that. I think I can't remember where it was. I ordered a pint of Coke and the glass had lipstick marks on. And it's
nice.
I think.
I
think I was a bit disgusted by it, and I didn't really want to say anything.
Did you ever complain to the barmaid?
The people at the bar seemed really nice, and I didn't want to upset them. So I was just, thank you. I think it was at one of our gigs.
Stop wearing lipstick then.
Yeah, it wasn't actually a woman's lipstick.
It was Joe's lipstick.
Joe took a slide.
That was somewhere else.
So, do you guys want to play another song?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so, introduce your song and take it away.
This one's another slow one, isn't it? We're going to do Losing My Religion. Just a dream,
That was just a dream. That's me in the corner. That's me in the spotlight, losing my religion. Trying to keep up with you, and I don't know if I can do it. Oh no, I said too much. I said enough. I thought that I heard you laughing. I thought that I heard you sing. I think I thought I saw you try. That was just a dream. Why try? Why cry? That was just a dream. Just a dream. Just a dream. Dream, dream.
James from Lies and the Bear, and you were listening to Unsigned Live with Charlie and Mark.
Yes, you're
Hello.
Listening to Unsigned Live with Charlie and Mark, and you just heard Bad Religion.
Losing My Religion.
Oh, I don't know.
That was really good.
By covered by Celestine.
No, are your hands getting sore yet?
No.
You're not getting sore from all that clapping?
Yeah, I don't like it. I thought a clap would sound more nicer than a tambourine. I don't know why.
It sounded good. I liked it. Yeah. I liked the clapping.
Did you take courses in clapping?
Yeah, I'm grade 6 in clapping.
Grade 6?
Mm.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Flying.
Some crazy rhythms going on there.
Did you get a distinction in grade 6?
Pardon?
Did you get a distinction in grade 6?
Yeah.
Wow.
Could you display some of your clapping techniques to us right now?
Little things like...
Okay. Right, I think we should. This deserves for a clapping masterclass, right?
Okay. Yeah. Maybe we should turn the backing down. Okay,
yeah.
It's a bit serious.
Yeah. So yeah. Should we? Do you want to teach us some basics? Everyone else can join in.
Okay. So you're grade 6. I think me and Charlie start at like grade 1. Perhaps.
Okay.
We're not natural born clappers like you.
No.
I've been able to play the clap really good.
So why don't
that is impressive.
Let's give that a round of applause.
He's just like, I feel like we've just done our grade 1 clapping.
was that a grade 1?
Yeah, that was excellent.
Oh wow.
So that's do you think we have time to do grade 2?
Okay.
Can you teach us a grade 2 maneuver?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
You can just clap.
Yeah.
Stop.
Yeah.
Clap 2 times. Stop. Finish.
Oh, great. Right. Should we try this?
Can you count us in?
Yeah.
5, 4.
Joel can do it. Joel do better.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh,
that's my grade 2 clapping exam.
Wow, that was good. That was good. So why did you choose that song, Losing My Religion?
Because all the others are too loud to play.
I'm a big R.E.M. fan. Well, all of us are. And we've always fancied doing one by them. So, that was just the one that we picked. I hope we do more by them.
It's one everyone knows, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah.
We tried one before, didn't we, of those? Which one was that one again? It wasn't Losing My Religion.
Mr. Frequency
Kenner.
He's Mr. Now.
So what kind of audience do you have playing at your gigs?
Well, we usually, our target audience is people at our age.
Yeah?
But... So obviously, some of the pubs that we're playing, there's like older people there, so it's kind of hard to try and get their attention. But when we play stuff like the Beatles or the Cult, they seem to be interested.
Yeah.
So.
Have you had in my day.
Have you had any crazy crowd surfing women?
Oh, yeah. Oof. One came up on the stage, can you remember that? When we played at the cricket club.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
No, we played at the cricket club and this woman took my tambourine.
Oh, wow.
She stood next to him.
So does being in a band help with getting the ladies?
Or the men?
Yeah.
Joe is the guy to talk to.
Joe doesn't need a band.
He's swimming over Joe.
Yeah.
So he's 4 eyes, you see.
I don't know. That's why they formed the band. It's
We thought we wanted some of that action, to be honest, but we can't get it. It's the always something around you.
I'm the front man, really.
Yeah.
It's not actually Elliot singing in our gigs. It's just a backing track of Joe's voice.
I suppose you need people to look like it's a band. I mean, one person doing it all would just look a bit short-y.
Yeah.
So, what do the parents think of the band? We actually graced with the presence of having some behind the scenes people in the studio.
Do you approve of Celestine?
No, not really.
Oh.
Well, why do you not?
No, they're all right. Me and Paul, we're just in the background all the time. We do all the humping about and driving the vans and making sure they put the gear up. Because if we don't do it, they won't do it.
You mentioned Paul was the bouncer.
Oh, you better believe it.
If I was like to like attack Joe or anyone, not targeting Joe,
you wouldn't go off your seat. He would sense it.
He would sense it.
Oh yes. Wow. Just ask him.
Yes, I would send
you. Wow.
So don't try.
Okay, so that was an exclusive from Celestine's parents there.
Millie Hall's been in touch.
Josh one.
And she says, great choice of song, boys. Celestine. They were great. Can't hear Jack say anything, though. Get him talking.
Come on, Jack.
Talk, Jack. He's very quiet, Jack. He's just cool.
I'm one of them people, aren't I?
You're one of the people.
Because you're a person.
I'm kind of guy who speaks when spoken to.
So, Jack, have you ever had an electric shock?
Have
you seen it?
On the slides.
That was just yesterday.
On the slides.
Yeah. So, Jack, how many caravan parks have you played?
One.
Yeah. Just one?
I think so.
It had a house as well. That was brilliant.
So, is a caravan gig extremely wild? Because no one has to drive home?
Well, I suppose so, yeah.
Bingo, it was good.
Yeah. It was like three games of bingo. It was brilliant.
Yeah, because after it,
90-year-old people, like,
it was
then we had that, like, mad Scottish guy came up to us after. He was like, you're the best band I've ever heard. All right, cheers.
I don't think he knows who we are now. He was very drunk that night.
He was like mad about the Stone Roses and stuff. It was great.
Oh, he took his shoes off, didn't he?
Yeah. He picked up like the tambourines and started dancing like when we were playing Stone Roses. It was excellent. He was like a pop model of Carl Pilkington.
I can see him now.
Taking his shoes off.
What are your plans for the future?
World domination.
Before that.
Aside that, I've actually planned that. I had some serious thinking one night when I was drunk.
Oh, okay.
That it would be pretty cool to do, like, you know, the live air type thing.
Right.
Do my own one.
Okay.
But with these guys, obviously. And it's going to be called Celestade. And in 10 years' time, it's going to happen.
Ten years.
So we've got a bit
10 years to get big.
Yeah.
Oh, so, yeah, oh, we're so never it's, gonna it's, do it. It's something as big as Live Aid.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be Wembley.
So is it Wembley?
Yeah.
It's bigger now, though.
It's going to be on the moon.
Absolutely.
No, that's not bad.
Oh, yeah, we have tried to contact the O2 Academy.
Yeah, we've had messages with like the O2 Academy in Newcastle and stuff, so we're trying to do as much as we can. We're actually on writing an album too.
Slowly but surely.
How many tracks have you got for that then?
One and a half. Well,
we have the makings
I've
of
got
about
over 50, but
yeah, we have the makings of about four so far, I think. It's just getting them done really, and then
practiced, yeah.
Have you got a name for the album yet? Any names in mind?
So, well, we know the front cover is just going to be Joe's face.
Yeah.
And we're going to have like...
Good choice.
Hopefully that'll boost up.
Yeah. And name of the album.
What?
God, what could we name the album?
Yes, sir.
Just Joe.
Joe.
What would you price it at?
Oh, man. I don't know what's it even worth.
It's just come out and that's £8. So.
Think fair.
Well, U2's album's just come out and it's
free. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So we're doing something.
Unfortunately, no one's going to download
ours
it.
Ours will be better.
Unfortunately, it's U2 and no one's going to buy it.
We'll give you money.
We'll give you the album and money.
£5 inside the case.
You'll pay us to take it
up. Yeah, because no one else will have it.
If we charge like £10, you'll pay £5.
My name is Diana Hall, and you are listening to Charlie and Mark on Bishop FM.
Here come old Flats up, he come grooving up slowly. He got Juju Apple, he won. Holy roller, he got hand down to his knee. Got to be a joker, he just do what he please.
That was Come Together by the Beatles, performed by Celestine.
I thought it was the Beatles.
The real live ones?
I thought they were there.
John's back.
Yeah, that was great. I'm loving the solo there.
Yeah, great solo. Do you have a pedal? Is there a pedal? I didn't realise.
Oh, it's just acoustic.
well done. So, we're coming to the end of a show.
Oh.
But we have a few messages have just come in. So, go back.
Yeah.
So Martin's been in touch, and he says, "Go on, Big Feet, Fena."
Fena.
Oh, Fena Junior.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And who else has been in touch, Mark?
Some guy says, loving those tambourine sounds.
Yeah, so as well as being a professional clappist, you're a professional tambourine player as well.
It
definitely worked better under the table.
Yeah.
And tambourine's better than that one.
Tambourine competition here.
Jaws is yellow, it's pretty cool.
Don't feel inadequate with that tambourine. I think you play it very well.
Thank you very much.
It's alright.
So, where can we find you on the internet if we want to find a bit more about Celestine?
Facebook. We're on making a website, which I'm doing. But at the moment, we have Facebook and everything you need to know is on there. It's just Celestine UK, really.
To follow, type in Celestine,
on Facebook
or add us or follow us to find out anything. We're always posting stuff on.
So
each one of us always posts something different.
Something's
on the page.
Unsigned Live with Charlie and Mark.